So Miss, now I needed a space to work, and Mr. In the variety store, there was a furnace room, and there was the furnace, and there was just enough room to put a Chesterfield up. So that's where I was working. And I always said, because there was something new for the people was always looking through the door what I was doing. And I was, and one day his insurance man came in, and I thought he had a heart attack. Me as an upholsterer, I'm as old, furniture and felt and everything that is highly flammable right next to the furnace. Mr. Wim said, enough land. So he sold our company, our lot, right next to him, where now Lincoln Interior is, for $1,000. And gave himself me a credit to pay that back. And then he went to his father, and his father gave us a loan, I think it was $1,000. So I went to Mr. Enz, the father of Harry, you know, and said, I need wood to build a shack, a workshop for upholstering. So he said, but I don't have any money, but I can make you a three-piece Chesterfield. And we had done a few things already, so he knows the quality was good. So he agreed. So I built just the first shop was on cedar posts, no foundation or anything, and tentestar, 2x4 framing, tentestar on the outside, and a roof, and right in the middle, and again, an old Franklin stove. And that was 24x36. Yeah. And we always had people coming in and looking. Oh, and people knew what I was doing, and all of a sudden, a school friend of mine, Heine Esau, came and asked. He said, "But you want to help me?" He said, "Yeah." He worked on a farm in Vineland, so he came and we started. Our upholstering business, and it went very well. My wife that time, she came, Mrs. Rempel, I needed a sewing machine, and she had an old sewing machine with a hand coat, so it was very awkward, and it didn't make a good job. And one of the first jobs I finished and had to make cushion, the woman who said, "Oh, this looks like a farmer's wife," was sewing the cushions. So I said, "My partner, I have to have an upholstering sewing machine, and I know that's $300. He said, "Let's go up to Mr. Regier and ask him for a loan." He said, "How can he give me money? I really don't have any." any security. Oh, yeah. You go up. And I went up that dusty old little cracky stairs again, and shaky. And I said, Mr. Regier, can you lend me $300? He said, yeah, sure. No problem. Yeah, the cadet committee will meet this evening. You can pick up your chair tomorrow morning, or your check tomorrow morning. And sure enough, I had the check. I jumped in the van again and went to Toronto, bought the sewing machine. And then I really won business.